a lot of you tell me that you like the little subtle things that I do on the terminal when I'm, you know, showing you something or doing a tutorial, because you learn from those subtle little commands and things like that. Thank you so much for those amazing comments. I really appreciate. So in this video, I just wanted to show you five of my favorite commands. I mean, there's so many favors. Actually, let's do six. I'm gonna do six commands for you to do things more efficiently using Kali Linux, which is the goal. It's much quicker to use the terminal, and I'll show you how. All right, so here's the first command. When I'm using a new tool in Kali Linux, the first thing that you have to do is learn about it. You can't just throw in stuff because it won't work. You have to learn about the tools, the arguments, and all of that stuff that comes with the tools inside of the terminal. So you can do a few things. The first one is man nmap, for example. Let's say we're learning about nmap. Man nmap is going to give you the entire manual for nmap. And as you can see, it's ridiculous. It's really long and you don't have time to deal with all of this stuff and learn the tool in so much detail that you go crazy. You can also do nmap help, for example, and that's going to give you a set of arguments and things like that. But as you can see, again, it's a lot of information and sometimes you just don't have the time for doing this kind of stuff. So the first tool is TLDR, right? So TLDR nmap, it's going to give you all the information that you need on and nothing else, right? And it's very easy to understand. Check if an IP address is up and gets the remote host operating system. Boom, there it is. This is the TLDR command, and it's one of my favorites because I can get information for tools very quickly. And this is one of those commands that I always throw in when I'm doing tutorials and people actually talk about them. To install it, sudo app install TLDR, enter your password and get it installed. So that's super easy to do. That would be the first command that I can show you. So here's the second command. Let's suppose you created a file and you have no idea where you put it. You just don't remember. And that happens to me all the time. I'm human, you're human. We all do it all the time. You can use commands like find, for example. So this is a find command to try to find information. You can also use, let's say, which, right? So which code in the case of Visual Studio Code, and it will tell you where the binary for Visual Studio Code is. But my favorite is locate. If you want to install it, you just do sudo app install plocate. There you go. And then you do a TLDR plocate, and all you have to do is just plocate and a pattern. And you also have to do a sudo update db, which is this, right? So let's do an update of the database, update db, and then let's find a file. So plocate my file txt, and there it is. This is where I left my file. So if I do a cd home dan local share ls, here's my file. So that is plocate. Now let's move on to the next one. The next one is to open applications, which is also great. And it is just the and sign or an ampersand. If I'm using, let's say, VS Code and I want to open it, let's say I'm here in share. So I'm here on share, right? And you can see all the files and stuff that I have on share. Then all I do is just type in code dot and then ampersand. And that's going to open code and it's going to show me everything inside of that folder. So here's my file, for example, right? So here's all the information. Now, let me just kill this. So by using the ampersand, you open a new process, but you can still use your terminal. So let's do it the same with sublime. So sublime, it would be sublime, and then dot, and then and, then it opens sublime text, right? And then here are all the files. You can just open different files using your terminal, and then just if you put the ampersand at the very end, it detaches the program, the process is going to detach from the terminal, so the terminal can be used for other things. Now here, as you can see, I'm in local share, so let's go somewhere else. I'm going to go to cd etc apache sites available. So now I'm here and I'm going to show you the third command that I love, which is the cd dash command. So if I type in cd dash, then I go back to where I was before. So I can continue to work in here, right? So let's suppose I'm working in this folder and then I need to jump to the last folder where I was. Then I type in cd dash and I go back to where I was. So I don't have to type in cd, say home, then local share. I can just type in cd dash and I'm back to where I was before. So that's really convenient. Now, if you don't know cd, you can do two more commands with the cd. The first one is they see the squiggly line. I don't know what's that called. You tell me. I go back to home. So this is the home folder for the username Dan. Now, if I type in cd slash, then I go to the main partition of my operating system. Now, the other one is, let's suppose I'm doing a penetration test and I need to get my IP addresses. I type in IPA, right? So here are all my IP addresses. And as you can see, it could get very messy in here. You can also do ifconfig, right? So ifconfig will give you all the information as well. But again, it's very messy. A quick and dirty way to get your IP address is just type in hostname dash capital I. There you go. So this is my IP address. And then you can see my Docker IP addresses in here as well. So that's very easy to do, right? So hostname dash I is another good command that I use all the time. And the last command I'm going to show you tonight is the output direction. So the arrow like this or arrow like this. So let's suppose I do an ls. I'm going to touch a file like that. And now I'm going to put information on that file. I can do echo. This is my text. And then I can output this to the file. Now, if I do cat my file, then you'll see that my text is being copied into the file. Now, if I say, for example, this is my book, and then I output that into the file, it's going to overwrite whatever it is inside that file. So if I do cat my file again, you'll see that now it says, this is my book. But if I put echo, and then this is my text like that, and then I put two arrows in there, it's going to write it right underneath. So now if I do cat my file, you'll see that it's in there. I love doing this. Now let's use it with nmap, for example. So if I'm going to do nmap, and then I put the IP address in here, and then I redirect to scan.txt, let's just do that and see what happens. There you go. So now if I do an ls, you'll see that there is a new file called scan.txt. And if I do cat scan.txt, there you go. So you see how it's outputted all the nmap information into that file, which is really good. That's what you want, right? So if I just do this on the terminal for nmap, it's going to provide me the information. Now I'm going to have to copy this, and I'm going to have to put it in a file and then save and all of that stuff. I don't have to do any of that stuff because the output direction command is great in Linux. And that's it. I hope you had fun. I hope you learned something, and probably maybe next weekend can post more commands that I use. So make sure you subscribe. If you have any questions, let me know, and I'll see you next time.